JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for August the 26th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, that will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against most of the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It gained slightly only against JPY and CHF, while it was found virtually unchanged versus the Canadian dollar. The greenback underperformed against AUD, NZD, GBP and the euro in that order. Now, the weakening of the US dollar and the other safe havens JPY and CHF combined with the strengthening of the Aussie and Kiwi suggests that the financial community largely continued to trade in a risk-on manner. Turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that indeed this has been the case, but up until the Asian trading. The only exception was Germany's DAX, which may have slid after the expectations index of the IFO survey slid by more than expected, underscoring companies' concerns for the coming months due to rising coronavirus infections. During the Asian trading today, the picture was turned upside down, perhaps after the Central Bank of South Korea became the first developed economy to hike interest rates during the pandemic. This may have been a signal that more developed nations may soon start withdrawing their support introduced for defending their economies from the coronavirus-related hits. In any case, recently we saw Asian stocks underperforming their European and US peers, perhaps due to concerns over tight regulations in China, as well as the recent fast spreading of the coronavirus over the continent. Now, EU and US shares may have continued to trend north, perhaps due to Monday's positive news on Pfizer's vaccine approval. However, as we've been repeatedly highlighting this week, investors were likely to become more cautious as we get closer to the Fed's annual Economic Symposium, and the modest gains, and yesterday's modest gains, prove just that. Now, investors will be eager to find out whether Fed Chair Powell will announce a clear plan and timeline with regards to quantitative easing taper. Expectations over a formal announcement and the start as early as next month have been high, at least until last week, due to stronger than expected employment and inflation data, but also due to the minutes of the latest meeting revealing that officials largely anticipate the process to begin this year. However, on Friday, Dallas Fed President Robert Kaplan said that he might reconsider his hawkish stance if the virus hurts the economy, while on Monday data showed that business activity in the US slowed for a third straight month due to the virus spreading. This may have lessened confidence that Powell will provide a clear quantitative easing tapering timeline. Even if he does, many believe that he may refrain from rocking the boat and perhaps announce only a cautious tapering, perhaps a start in December and a reduction pace of $10 billion. Bearing in mind that the Fed is currently buying $120 billion USD worth of asset purchases, this means that the full process would take a full year, something that could result in later rate hikes as well. Now, in case he refrains to provide a clear roadmap, a scenario we see as the most likely Incoming employment and inflation data may become even more important as they could prove determinant on how the Fed will act at its upcoming gatherings. Now, as for today's events, an event that may attract some attention may be the minutes from the latest ECB gathering. At that meeting, the bank kept all of its settings untouched and changed its forward guidance, saying that it will keep interest rates at present or lower levels until it sees inflation reaching 2% well ahead of the end of its projection horizon, which may also imply a period during which inflation moderately overshoots that objective. This translates into willingness to hold rates low for much longer than the previous guidance suggested. So with that in mind, we don't expect to get any major new information from the minutes, but we will look for any possible hints with regards to officials' plans over their asset purchase program beyond March, which is the current planned end date. We also get the second estimate of the US GDP for the second quarter, which is expected to be revised up to 6.7% quarter over quarter, seasonally adjusted rate from 6.5%, and the initial jobless claims for last week, with the forecast pointing to a fractional increase. That said, with all eyes locked on the Fed's Economic Symposium, we see the case for this data to receive little, if any, attention. We also have one speaker on today's agenda, and this is ECB Executive Board member Isabel Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.